spirits? Whither wander you?
Over hill, over dale, through bush, through briar, over park, over pale, through flood, through fire. I do wander everywhere, swifter than the moon's sphere, and I serve the fairy queen to dew her orbs upon the green. In their gold spots, you see, those be rubies, fairy favors, in those freckles live those savors. I must go seek some dewdrops here and hang a pearl in every cowslip there. Farewell, thy love of spirits, I'll be gone. Our queen and all of our elves, come here anon.
The king doth keep his revels here tonight. Take heed, the queen not come within his sight. For Oberon is passing fell in wrath, that the queen as her attendant hath a lovely boy stolen from an Indian king. She never held so sweet a changeling, and jealous Oberon would have the child knight of his train to keep the forest wild. But she perchance withhold the loved boy, crown him with flowers, and make him all her love and joy. But they don't meet, not by grove or green, by fountain clear or spangled starlight sheen. But they do swear that all the elves for fear should creep into acorn cups and hide them there.
Either I mistake your shape or make him quite, or else are that shrewd and knavish sprite. Call it Robin, good fellow. Are you not he that frights the maidens of the village tree? Skim milk and sometimes labour in the crane, and booze make the breathless housewife turn, and sometimes make the drink to bear no bear. Misled might wanderers laugh at their harm. Those that hobgoblin call you, crown's sweet puck. You do their work, and they shall have good luck. Are you not he?
Thou speakest all right. I am that merry wanderer of the night. I jest to Oberon and make him smile, when I, a fraps and beanfell horse beguile, neighing in likeness of a filly foal, sometimes a guy in a gossip's bowl, and the wisest aunt telling the saddest tale, sometimes a 3-foot stool mistaketh me, and then I slip from her bum, down topples she, and tailor she cries out, and the whole choir hold their hips and laugh, waxen in their worth and need, and swear that a merrier hour was never there. But whom? Mary, here comes Oberon.
And here, my mistress, what's that you were gone?
Ill met by moonlight, proud Titania.
What? Jealous Oberon? Fairies, skip hence. I have forsworn his bed and company.
Tarry! Rash wanton, am not I thy lord's?
Then I must be thy lady's. But I know when thou hast stolen away from Fairyland, and in the shape of Corin sat all day playing on the pipes of corn and versing love to amorous Philida. Why art thou here? Come from the farthest stoop of India? But that, forsooth, the bouncing Amazon. Your buskined mistress and your warrior love to Theseus must be wedded. And you come to give their bed joy and prosperity.
How canst thou thus, for shame, Titania? Knowing I know thy love to Theseus, glance at my credit with Hippolyta. Didst thou not lead him through the glimmering night from Perigenia, whom he ravished, and make with fair Aegles break his faith with Ariadne and Antiope?
These are the forgeries of jealousy. And never since middle summer spring met we on hill and dale, forest or mead, by paved mountain or by rushy brook, or in the beached emergence of the sea to dance our ringlets to the whistling wind. But with thy brawls thou hast disturbed our sport. Therefore the winds, piping to us in vain as in revenge, have sucked up from the sea contagious fogs, which falling on the land hath every pelting river made so proud they have overborne their continents. No knight is not with him or carried less. Therefore the moon, governess of floods, pale in her anger, washes the air that a rheumatic diseases do about. And for this disintemperature we see the seasons alter. Hoary-headed frost fall in the fresh lap of the crimson rose, and on old time's thin and icy crown, an odorous chaplet of sweet summer buds is as in mockery set. The spring, the summer, childing autumn, angry winter change their wanton liveries. And the mazed world by their increase now knows not what which is which. And this same progeny of evils comes from our dissension, from our debate. We are their parents and original.
Do you mend it then? It lies in you. Why should Titania cross her Oberon? I do but beg a little changeling boy to be my henchman.
Set your heart at rest. The fairyland buys not the child of me. His mother was a votress of my order. And in the spiced Indian air, full often had she gossiped by my side. and sat with me on Neptune's yellow sands marking the embarked traders of the floods, where we have laughed to see the sails grow big-bellied with the wanton wind, with she, with pretty and with swimming gait following, her womb then rich with my young squire would imitate, and sail upon the land to fetch me trifles, and return again as from a voyage, rich with merchandise. But she being mortal of that voyage did die, and for her sake I do rear up her boy, and for her sake I will not part him.
How long within this wood intend you stay?
Perchance till after Theseus' wedding day, if you will patiently dance in our rounds and see our moonlight revels come with us. If not, shun me, and I will spare thy haunts.
Give me that boy, and I will go with thee.
Not for thy fairy kingdom. Fairies, away! We shall chide downright if I longer stay.
Well, go thy way. Thou shalt not from this grove till I torment thee for this injury. My gentle buck, come hither. Thou rememberest since once I sat upon a promontory and heard a mermaid on a dolphin's back uttering such dulcet and harmonious breath that the rude sea grew civil with her song, and certain stars shot madly from their spheres to hear the sea maid's music?
I remember.
That very night I saw, but thou couldst not. Flying between the cold moon and the earth, Cupid, all armed, a certain aim he took at a fair vestal throned by the west, and loosed his love shaft smartly from his bow as it should pierce 100,000 hearts. But I might see young Cupid's fiery shaft quenched in the chaste beams of the watery moon, and the imperial votaress passed on in maiden meditation, fancy free. Yet marked I where the bolt of Cupid fell. It fell upon a little western flower, before milk white and now purple with love's wound, and maidens call it love in idleness. Fetch me this flower. To her I showed thee once. For the juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make our manor woman madly dote upon the next light creature that it sees. Fetch me this herb, and be thou here again ere the Leviathan can swim a league.
I'll put a girdle around here in 40 minutes.
With the juice of this I will watch Titania, she is asleep, and drop the liquor of it in. Next thing then she waking looks upon, be it on lion or bear or wolf or bull or meddling monkey or busy ape, she shall pursue it with the soul of love. And ere I take this charm from off her sight, as I can take it with another herb, I'll make her render up her page to me.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not.
But who comes here? I am invisible. Overhear their conference.
Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? The one I'll slay, the other slayeth me. Thou told me they were stolen into this wood, and here am I, and wood within this wood, because I cannot see my Hermia. Hence, get thee gone, and follow me no more.
You draw me, you hard-hearted adamant, yet you draw not iron, for my heart is true as steel. Leave you your power to draw, and I shall have no power to follow you.
Do I entice you? Do I speak you fair? Or do I not, in plainest truth, tell you that I do not nor I cannot love you?
And even for that, do I love you the more? I'm your spaniel, and Demetrius, the more you beat me, I will fawn on you. Use me but as your spaniel, spurn me, strike me, neglect me, lose me, only give me leave, unworthy as I am, to follow you. What worse a place can I beg in your offer, and such a place of high respect to me, than to be used as you use your dog?
Tempt not too much the hatred of my soul, for I am sick when I do look on thee.
I am sick when I look not on you.
You do impeach your modesty too much. To leave the city and entrust yourself into the hands of one that loves you not. To trust the opportunity of night and the ill counsel of a desert place with the rich worth of your virginity.
Your virtue is my privilege, for that it is not night when I do see your face. Therefore I think I am not in the night. Nor doth these woods lack worlds of company for you. My respect are all the world's. Then how
legs and leave thee to the mercy of wild beasts.
The wild just hath not such a heart as you. Run when you will, the story shall be changed. Apollo flies and Daphne holds the chase. The dove pursues the griffin. The mild hind makes speed to catch the tiger. Bitless feet, when cowardice pursues and banner flies.
I will not say thy question. Let me go, or if thou stay, do not doubt, but I shall do thee mischief in the woods.
Aye, in the temple, the town, the field, you do me mischief. Oh, fie, Demetrius, you're wrong to do such a scandal on my sex. We cannot fight for love as men may do. We should be wooed. We're not made to woo. Oh! I'll follow thee and make a heaven of hell to die upon the hand I love so well.
Fare thee well, nymph. Ere he do leave this grove, thou shalt fly him, and he shall seek thy love. Hast thou the flower there?
Aye.
Welcome, wanderer.
Aye, here it is.
I pray thee, give it to me. I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where the ox slips and nodding violet grows, quite over canopied with luscious woodbine, with sweet musk roses and with eglantine. There sleeps Titania sometime in the night, lulled in these flowers with dances and delight. There the snake throws her enameled skin, weed wide enough to wrap a fairy in. With the juice of this, I'll streak her eyes and make her full of hateful fantasies. But take thou some of it, and seek through this grove. A sweet Athenian lady is in love with a disdainful youth. Anoint his eyes, but do it so when the next thing he espies may be the lady. Thou shalt know the man by the Athenian garments he hath on. Affect it with some care, that he may prove more fondly upon her than she upon her love. And look thou, meet me here, the first cock crow.
Fear not, my lord, your servant shall do so.